Now we have done what are cubes and cube roots, what were the properties based on cubes and cube roots, and we have also studied some patterns in the cube roots. Now we will be discussing the actual questions that come from this chapter, that is how to find cubes and cube roots. Now the first question says that what is the cube of 10 minus 6 and 21. Now let us solve each of them separately. The first one is the cube of 10. I am doing the first question. What will be the cube of 10? We have already done that what is meant by the word cube. Cube means the number is getting multiplied 3 times. So over here we will multiply 10 3 times and we would get 10 into 10 equal to 100 into 10, that will be equal to 1000. Similarly, what will be the cube of minus 6? The cube of minus 6 will be equal to minus 6 into minus 6 into minus 6. This will be equal to minus minus plus, and plus and minus will become again minus only. So 6 is 36, and 36 into finally minus 6 will be equal to minus 216. Next is calculating the cube of 21. Again, 21 into 21 into 21, that will be equal to, let us solve, 21 into 21 will be equal to 1, 2, 2, 4, 1, 4, 4, 441. Now this was when you multiplied 221s. Further multiplying it with 21, what do you get? You get 1, 4, 4, 2, 8, 8. Now on solving you get 12, 9. So the answer for this is 9, 2, 6, 1. This was how to find the cube roots. Now next we will be doing is finding the cube roots of these numbers. Now for finding the cube roots, I have a method particularly known as the prime factorization method. As we have done factorization in our earlier chapters, in our earlier classes, we have come across the term LCMs, right? So this is nothing but only finding the factors. That is why this method is known as prime factorization method. So when you have to find the cube root for any number, what you have to do? You have to find its factors at first. Let us solve the first question. The first part of the question is finding the cube root of 216. Now before writing the cube root, I will have to represent it in the cube root form. So I will make this sign. Now this represents that we are finding the cube root of 216. How do we find that? Now your prime factorization method says that you have to find the factors of the number first. So what will be the factors for 216? Let us start with 2. 2 ones are 2. It goes with 0. So 1 and 6 comes together. 1, 0, 8. Now again 2, 5 and 4. 2, 2 and 7. Now 3, 9. 3, 3 and 3, 1. That means what are the factors that I've got? I'll write it in the same form. Now my 216 can be written as what? The multiplication of the factors, the product of the factors, that will be 2 into 2 into 2 into 3 into 3 into 3. Now this was the first step that you have to do. The first step was finding the factors and writing it in this format. The next step is that you have to do the grouping of the terms. Now here what are you going to find? You are finding the cube roots. That is, you are finding the number which will be multiplied 3 times. So what you do here? You do the grouping of 3 numbers. Now here if we do the grouping of 3 numbers, we get here all the 3 2's get grouped together and all the 3's will get grouped together. So what do we get? When these 2 will come out of the square root, they will be coming as single only. Similarly, when these group of 3 will come out of the cube root, it will come as 3 only. So what do we get? 6. That means what is the cube root of 216? It is equal to 6. Similarly, let us solve the next question, which says we have to find the cube root of 4096. Now nothing except finding the factors at first. Let us find the factors for 4096. Now the factors for 4096 would be 2 0 4 8 2 1 2 4. Now here 2, 5, 1, 2, 2, 2's are, then 11 remains, 2, 5's are 10 and 1 remains 12, 2, 6 are 12. Now again with 2, 2 1's are 2, 2, 2's are 4, 1 remainder 16, 2, 8's are 16. 2, 6 and 4. 2, 3, 2, 2, 1, 6, 2, 8, 2, 4, 2, 2, and finally 2, 1. Now here we have to write all these factors in the cube root section. Now let us write how many 2's are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 12 2's are there. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. I have written down all the 2's in the cube root section. Now is the time to group them. Now how to group them? 3. In groups of 3, you have to divide them. Okay, now what will come outside? This group of 2, out of this group we get only 2. From this we get 2, 2 and 2. So 2 2's are 4, 4 2's are 8 and 8 2's are 16. So what do we get as the cube root of 4096? That is 16. You can also check your answers on your own. How do you check? That's simple. If this is the cube root of 216, then that means if you multiply 6 with 6 3 times, if you do the cube of 6, you should get 216. Let us check. Okay, how to check the question? This is, I am telling you, for your own purpose. You don't really get any question in which you have to check your answers, right? Just for your helping purpose. What will be the cube of 6? This will be 6 into 6 into 6. 6 6 is 36. 36 into 6. If you do 36 into 6, you would get 6 6 is 36. 3 carry. 6 3 is 18. 19, 20, 21. That means 6 has the cube 216 and 216 is known as the cube root of 6. Similarly, let us check for the case of 16 also. If you multiply 16 3 times, what do you get? Let us multiply 16 into 16 first. 6 6 are 36, 3 carry. 6 1 is 6 plus 3, 9. 6 and 1. 6, 9 plus 6 becomes 15. 1 becomes 2. Now 256 again multiplied with 16, what would you get? You would get 6 6 is 36, 3, 6 5 is 30 plus 3, 33, 6 2 is 12, 13 14, 15. Now 1 will give you 1, 6 is 6, 1 5 is 5, 1 2 is 2 and 3. 6 remaining as it is, 6 plus 3 9, 5 plus 5 10, 2 3 and 4, 3. Now see, you can check your answer. I've got here 4096. Now, in this question also, you can write it directly 4096. Now, here we can write it as 6 has the cube equal to 4096. And what do we have as the cube root of 4096? We have 16. Now, that is how you check your answers, right? So, by these questions, I hope that you have become clear with how to find the cubes. Cubes are just to multiply the number 3 times and you get the cubes. And how to find the cube roots? There is one method only to find cube roots. That is, you find the prime factorization, right? You find the factors, group them into 3, bring them out of the cube root and multiply them. That will give you the cube roots.